If you're considering rolling out Chrome hardware for your business and you're unsure of where to start, well, in this video, I'm going to take you through the process of how you can evaluate Chrome for your business, and we're going to even offer some support for where we may be able to help out with your process in going Google. The purpose of this video is to share with you a proof of concept methodology for you to properly evaluate considering rolling out Google Chrome to your organization. Now, if you're already a Google Workspace user and you're using the Google ecosystem, well, this is a great move for you and it's gonna slip right in to the processes that you've got already in terms of the ecosystem that you're using for your productivity tools. If you're in the Microsoft ecosystem and you're considering making a move to Google, well, this might be part of the puzzle to see what is the hardware like and what might the experience be like. Either way, I'm going to take you through a framework that's going to be really helpful here. Why is it important to have a proof of concept? Why would we try before we buy? Well, just like trying a new car, you want to take it for a bit of a test drive first and actually see how it feels, see what it drives like on the road, see what the fuel economy is like, and, you know, get a feel of a sense of what it would be like to be in a new reality. Now, a proof of concept is effectively doing the same thing. And what I love about Chrome and trying out a new operating system is it's a very tangible experience. You get to actually try it out yourself and see how it works. And I know from the thousands of people that we've helped adopt Chrome and adopt the Google Workspace ecosystem that Chrome is pretty darn exciting once you get it. Now, what does it take to get it with the Chrome operating system? Well, it's a little bit like Google Docs for the first time. You may be wondering where all the buttons are and wondering how to find your way. And after a while, you know, you might have a few grumbles about not having every single button that you had in Microsoft Word, but then all of the googly little features kind of pop in and show you the magic of what can be done when things are approached differently with a cloud-first mentality. Now, Google automatically update their operating system with a major update every 6 weeks that's delivered automatically down to all of their Chrome devices. Now, not only that, it automatically updates in the background, and so all it requires is a 10-second restart to install any updates because it's installed them in the background, unlike Mac or Windows PCs that can take up to an hour every time there's a major operating system upgrade. Some of the other great features of Google Chrome are the ability to have all of your files automatically synchronized to the cloud. Although you can still work offline if you want to, you can immediately work with all of your Google files right online and locally on the device as well. But let's go back to talking about the proof of concept. If you're considering using Chrome and you're interested in Chrome devices, how might you actually approach that as a technology team or as a leadership team in your business? Well, we're going to start by a proof of concept by identifying, well, you know, what's the purpose why we might consider moving to Chrome? Are we looking to save cost? Chrome devices are typically much cheaper than their counterparts in the Windows and PC world. Are we looking to perhaps reduce the amount of time that we spend organizing and supporting the devices that we have? Are we looking for more flexible options for our leasing, for us to potentially not tie up so much capital in leasing and look for different devices which have different length of life? Whatever the reason you're interested in Chrome, the first place for you to start is to actually outline some user profiles. And user profiles is basically looking at the different people in your business and identifying what their needs are. What are the needs of an executive? What are the needs of a frontline worker who's working in customer service? What are the needs of the marketing department? What are the needs of a middle manager? Now, do they need access to documents? Do they need access to video conferencing? Will they need to do graphic design with a particular program? What are all the apps that they're going to need to use on their day? And this is just a matter of going to each one of those people and developing a profile of exactly what their needs are. Are they someone who needs to be mobile? Are they in and out of the office? Or are they primarily working from one space in one desk space? Now, in the current paradigm, we are in a global pandemic and many people are working at home or from geographically dispersed locations. Do you have the flexibility with your devices which are going to meet the needs of each one of the user profiles? Now, many organizations have gone to the trouble of going laptops as a primary device and plugging them into external monitors. But for someone who's going to spend 90% to 95% of their time in one location, is that really appropriate if you've got the additional overhead of less bang for your buck with the power that you get on a laptop for actually the device that you receive? These are all questions that need to be asked for each different user profile, and you'll get a bit of an idea of what the requirements will be for the hardware, which is the next decision for you to make. Now, of course, there are some situations where a Chrome device might not be suitable for the person or the particular user role. A graphic designer or a video editor is probably going to need to be on a Mac so they can use something like the Adobe Suite to actually work with their organization. But that doesn't necessarily mean that a Chrome rollout or switching to Google across your business is a bad idea. Even if you were a graphic design firm, you might have all of your designers using Macs, but perhaps the executive team could all still use Chrome if you were interested. And this is not about a Chrome is the only way type message that I'm trying to share with you. This is, well, what is the best way and what are the best devices? And we believe Chrome are compelling devices because of their low cost, amazing functionality, and their ability to seamlessly integrate with the rest of the Google Workspace ecosystem, including easy to use policies right from the administration panel, which are automatically applied across your machines. You don't need to roll out any central service to manage them, and they're automatically updating every time they connect to the internet. So if you're an organization that has one or two or even a whole department of people who are not a good fit for switching to Chrome OS, don't let that stop the whole business in its tracks. Don't allow one excuse to stop the whole of an organization from moving forward with progress if this is a good move for the business. Because that would be like assuming that when you're purchasing a fleet of cars for the whole business, everyone gets a van just because one person needs to use a van for their work. So let's kind of circle back to how do we then move from our proof of concept to then going to rolling out Chrome. Now, once you've got all the user profiles organized, you then want to start testing. Start giving some people some laptops and getting their honest feedback, asking them, hey, how did this go for you? Try it out for a week. Give us some feedback, see how it goes. Maybe have your team write down everything that was easier to do, everything that was harder to do, and you know whether or not they felt that this was a change that would be worthwhile for them. Of course, bring back any of that feedback to a consultant that you're working with or anyone in the team who's responsible for the rollout, and you can then use that to develop an action plan and a strategy about what is the best way to roll and implement your Chrome OS into your teams. Finally, calculating a total cost of investment or return on investment calculation for the whole implementation of Chrome OS across your business is going to be the final step in evaluating whether or not this proof of concept is a good idea to move forward with. And some of the things that you can think about in there are, what are your support costs? What are your hardware refresh costs? What is the cost of devices? What is your ability to access devices when you need to ramp up new team members? How can you implement policies? And what is the administration overhead time that might be saved with moving to something like Chrome OS? Now, if you're interested in an audit of your current Chrome policies, if you're considering Chrome OS for your business and you're thinking about getting a little bit of help with considering a user trial, or maybe you want someone to come in and help run a proof of concept with you with devices who can give you expertise on where Chrome may be a good fit for you, well, I recommend you considering having a chat to our team on the audit link below. Once you fill out the form and select audit from our team, we'll get in touch and have a look at your Google Workspace account. Now, not only are we gonna look at make sure your DNS settings are correct and check that everything is configured correctly, we'll have a chat to you about some policies that might work for you in the Google Chrome world. And if you're eligible, we may even send you devices to help you with your trial of Google Workspace and Chrome OS devices. Look forward to helping you out. If you've got any questions, you can drop them in the comments. If you're not already subscribed to our channel, please hit the subscribe button. And if you like this video, give us a thumbs up. I'll see you on the next side and see you in the next video.